स्टैंडर्ड नाइन मैथ्स चैप्टर वन नंबर सिस्टम Now, before starting the exercise 1.3, I want to dictate something to remember. Now, remember, I have different fractions 1/4, 1/2. 1/20, 1/5, 1/8, 1/16. Now I'm multiplying. For getting it to be converted in decimal form, fractions to be converted in decimal form, I can multiply this number by 25. So it will be 25/100. We can write 0.25. Now understand what I have done here. 1/4 means 2 raised to square. Am I right? 1/4 is equals to 2 raised to square. Now for getting 100, same number of power of 5, I have to multiply. Suppose it is 2 raised to 2. Then I should multiply 5 raised to 2. Now 5 raised to 2 is 25, right? 5 raised to 2 is 25. Understand this, very important. Same way, if I have 1/2, I will multiply with 5. Answer will be 5/10, that is 0.5. 5/10. That is 0.5. So 1/2, that is 2 raised to 1 exponent. Then I have to multiply 5 raised to 1 exponent on numerator and denominator.
Now, sir, third it is one. Compulsory to do these exponents.
Yes, it's a conceptual work. Basics. I will explain how it is useful to you. Now 20. I multiply with 5. Then it will be 5/100, 0.05. Now what I have done here, understand. Very important. You all have to understand that 1/20 means 2 × 2 × 5. Already I have 2 raised to 2 and 5. So what I will multiply it with? 5. I will multiply it with 5. So here 2 raised to 2, 5 raised to 2. Same exponent of 2 and 5, you will get decimal points. You will get decimal points. Now here I can do with 2. So 2/10, 0.2. So 1/5 raised to 1, 2 raised to 1/2. One by eight. 125/125. Why it is so? 125/1000. 0.125. Now, if I can write in a decimal form in this way, just see what I have done. 1/8, that is 2 raised to cube. So same way I will require exponent of 5 also, 5 raised to 3. 5 raised to 3, that is 125. Now, 1/16, that is 6 to 5. Why I have done 2 raised to 4, then also 5 raised to 4. So whatever is the exponent of 2, same exponent of 5 to be taken to make the number denomination decimal, right? So 6 to 5 upon 10,000, 0.0625. Let's write it in this way. 1 upon 16 means 2 raised to 4. Same way, 5 raised to 4 upon 5 raised to 4. Right? So to obtain, I am writing now the fundamental here. To obtain decimal number in denomination, we should do 2 raised to m into 5 raised to n format. Very important. For obtaining decimal, 2 raised to 5, 5 raised to n, where m is equals to n. Means exponent of both should be equal, same. Exponent of both should be same, equal. Now exercise 1.3. Sum number 1. Write the following in decimal form and say what kind of decimal expansion each has. 36 upon 100. So answer will be 0.36. So it is terminating, not expanding, right? Terminating decimal expansion. The numbers are terminating, not continuing. If they are continuing, it is recurring or non-recurring. Terminating has another word, non-recurring. Decimal expansion. You can use any of the word from this. Second, 1/11. Now, let us divide 10 is also not divisible by 11. 11 nines are 99. 10, not divisible. 100, 11 nines are 99. So what I can see here, answer will be 0.0909 and so on. Right? It's recurring. So 0.09 bar. I will put bar on both 0 and 9. Means these two numbers are repeating. So it is called non-terminating
recurring decimals.
Very good. Recurring decimal expansion. Third one. Four integer 1/8. 4 to 8 plus 1. 33/8. Now, the law which I taught you is useful here. What is given? 8. With which number I should multiply? 125 to get perfect decimal. Why it is so? Because we are 2 raised to 3. So I have to multiply with 5 raised to 3. Clear, everyone? Clear? Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So 33 into 125 upon 8 into 125. Multiply 33 into 125, 4125 by 1000. That is 4.125. That is 4.125. Terminating decimal expansion. We should write terminating decimal expansion. Clear? Next, number 4. Three by 30. Let's divide. I am putting 4 zeros. 13 twos are 26. 4 zeros. 13 threes are 39. 10. Right? Then 0. I will put 100. 13 sevens are 91. 9. Again, I will put 0. 13 sixes are 78. 12. Again, I put 0. 120. 13 nines are 117. So what I will? It will be now 3. We have 3. Here again 3. So all this number will repeat. All this number will repeat. So can I write it in this way? It is, answer is 0.230769. It is recurring, non-terminating recurring decimal expansion. Non-terminating recurring decimal expansion. Non-terminating recurring decimal expansion. Next. Two by 11. Now, let's do 0000. 11 ones are 11. 11 eights are 88. 11 ones are 11. 11 eights are 88. So we can write 0.1880. Even we can do this. 2 by 11, that is 2 into 1 by 11. So 1 by 11 already we have found out 0.9009. So we can multiply 0.1818. Right?
Can we do this? Can we do this? So what we can
yes,
write?
Sir. Yes,
sir. 0.18. 0.18 is the repeating number. Non-terminating recurring decimal expansion. Non-terminating recurring decimal expansion. Six. 329 upon 400. Now, as per my opinion, what you should do? First of all, factorize 400. 2s are 200, 2s are 100, 2s are 50, 2s are 25, 5s are 5, and 5s are 1. So, what I will get? 2 raised to 4, 5 raised to 2. For getting decimal expansion, how much exponent I should multiply? 5 raised to 2. Clear? Now you will be clear what I am saying, right? So 329 into 25 upon 2 raised to 4, 5 raised to 4. Multiply 329 into 20, 329 into 25, 8225. And here 10 raised to 4. That will be 8225 upon 10,000. 0.8225. So, terminating decimal expansion. Answer. Terminating decimal expansion. Now, sum number 2. You know that 1 by 7, it is already given. 1 by 7 is equal to 0.142857. This is already given. Can you predict what the decimal expansion of 2 by 3, 2 by 7, 3 by 7, 4 by 7, 5 by 7 and 6 by 7 are? Without actually doing the long division. If so, how? Let's do it. Two by seven. What I have just stated, two into one by, that is two into 0.142857. Now just multiply, answer will be 0.285714. All will be repeating number. All will be repeating number. Let me write 3 by 7. So 3 into 1 by 7. 3 into 0.142857. That is 0.4285 71. The digits are changing. See, 4 has come to first place. All other are same. This 4 has come to first place. All other numbers are same. Then 4 by 7, 4 into 1 by 7, 4 into 0.142857, 0.571428, then 5/7. 5 × 1/7. 5 × 0.142857. So 0.714285. Then 6/7. 6 × 1/7. 6 × 0.142857. Answer will be 0.857142. Repeat. 857142. So this is just one number, and we can find out all the decimals, repeating decimals from there.